Hello everyone. Today I am going to deal with some of the solutions for problems based on commutator, Hermitian operator as well as normalization of wave function. So let's start. First I am going to derive the fundamental commutation relation and let's see what it gives. Here I am considering the commutator, that is inner product of position operator and linear momentum operator along x-axis. So when this is operated on an wave function xi, we know inner product of operator a cap and b cap is equals to a cap b cap minus b cap a cap. If you consider classical regime, we say that these physical quantities, which are nothing but the observables, they are going to cancel out. If you consider like this, it is something like AB minus BA, where you can easily cancel out to give 0. But in quantum regime, it is not so, because the observables are replaced by the operators and these are not going to cancel out directly. Why? Let us see. So here we have to just substitute the values of the operators. We know position operator x cap will be equal to x itself, whereas the momentum operator px cap will be equal to minus ih cross dou by dou x, which we have already derived. And the same thing we are substituting here. Here it is clear that x and xi both are depending on x itself. That is, if you consider dou by dou x differentiation with respect to x, x is also variable, xi is also variable. That's why the first term we can write as it is, because x is on left hand side. So we are writing minus ih cross x dou xi by dou x after taking xi inside the bracket. But for the second term, first comes the differential operator dou by dou x, and after that there are two variables, one is x and another one is xi. That's why we need to write it as plus ih cross, which is a constant, dou by dou x of x into xi. And here we need to use the formula, that is differentiation of u into v, which is nothing but u into differentiation of v plus v into differentiation of u. So first term as it is, second term will be by using the formula. So ih cross as it is, x I have taken outside, kept it constant, and dou xi by dou x plus ih cross is constant. Now xi I have kept as constant and dou x by dou x is nothing but 1. Clearly we can observe that first and second term are same and they can cancel out. And we are remaining with the inner product of x cap and px cap operating on wave function xi will be equal to ih cross into xi. So if you remove the wave function xi, we can see that commutator value will be equal to ih cross. And in my previous class, I had told that what we conclude from this commutation relations. That is, if the commutator is equal to 0, it means that the two quantities can be measured simultaneously. But if it is not equal to 0, it is giving certain value, then it is not measurable simultaneously. And here it is clearly seen that the commutator of position operator and momentum operator along the same direction is not equal to 0 but equal to ih cross. That's why we say that position and momentum cannot be measured simultaneously. And this is nothing but the uncertainty principle, where you say position and momentum cannot be measured simultaneously, and this is the mathematical framework behind that uncertainty principle. But if you consider different directions, that is y cap and px cap, and this same thing is carried out and solved for the commutator, it is going to be equal to 0. There we can see that the position along y direction and the momentum along x direction can be measured simultaneously. In the same way, using different operators, we can find out what are the values of commutators and finally give some conclusions out of it. So This is about the fundamental commutation relation. Then let us move on to prove that momentum operator is Hermitian. This is a basic problem where we understand how to get an operator as Hermitian, or how to check or verify whether an operator is Hermitian or not. For that, I am considering the example of momentum operator. So whether the momentum operator is Hermitian operator or no, let us prove it. For that, we need to know what is a Hermitian operator. And we know that the condition for Hermitian operator is integration from minus infinity to plus infinity of xi m star a cap xi n into dx is equals to integration from minus infinity to plus infinity of a cap xi m whole star into xi n dx is equals to integration from minus infinity to plus infinity of xi n star a cap xi m dx whole star. So if this condition is satisfied by any of the operator, it may be position, momentum, kinetic energy, energy, Hamiltonian, whichever operator you consider, or linear momentum, if this condition is satisfied, it means that the operator is Hermitian. So for proving a momentum operator as Hermitian, I am considering the second term of the definition of Hermitian operator, which is integration from minus infinity to plus infinity of a cap xi m whole star into xi n into dx. Here instead of a cap, I am writing a position momentum operator, which is px cap. In place of px cap, we need to substitute its value, which is minus ih cross dou by dou x. And it is having star mark over it, means we need to take the complex conjugate of it. So minus I will be converted into plus I, and as it is a constant, I am taking it outside the integral sign. So plus I h cross into integration from minus infinity to plus infinity of dou xi m star by dou x into xi n into dx, or even you can write dou xi m star into xi n. It is understood, it is with respect to any of the position operator or with respect to any coordinate. If you solve it further, again we need to use the formula, that is integration of u into v, which is nothing but u into integration of v minus integration of v into dou u. So the same thing we have used here and substituted, but I have considered xi n as u and dou xi m star by dou x as v. So when you use the formula, we are getting this equation, and it is clear that in first term, if you have the limit from minus infinity to plus infinity, we can just say it is going to vanish out based on m and n, and we are remaining with only the second term. And if you bring the constant minus ih cross inside the integration sign, we can see that it is nothing but the momentum operator. So we get the second term of the Hermitian operator, which we have considered, is equals to the first term, that is integration from minus infinity to plus infinity of xi m star px cap xi n into dx. So if these two are equal, it means that the operator px cap is Hermitian. So by the same method itself, we can prove different operators or verify whether the operators are Hermitian or no. So this is about the problem based on Hermitian operator. Next, let us move on to normalization of wave function. So I'm considering a simple example. And here we need to normalize a wave function xi of x is equals to a into exponential of minus bx square over a domain minus infinity to plus infinity. So x is lying in between minus infinity to plus infinity. It need not be always minus infinity to plus infinity. It may be from minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2 also. So it depends. So So normalization means we need the normalization condition, which is nothing but integration from minus infinity to plus infinity of xi star xi into dx is equals to 1. Xi is already given. We can directly write its conjugate xi star, and there is no complex term, that is I. That's why things are going to remain as it is. So substituting the value in the normalization condition, a star into a will be square of mod of a, and exponential terms are as it is, so we can write it as exponential of minus bx square into exponential of minus bx square, which will be equal to exponential of minus 2 bx square into dx, which should be equal to 1 according to the normalization condition. And we have the general formula with respect to these integrals, that is integration from minus infinity to plus infinity of exponential of minus x square dx is equals to root of pi by 1. If it is instead of x square we have minus ax square, we will be having the integral value equal to root of pi by a. In the same way, here the integral value will be equal to root of pi by 2b, because the constant associated with x square is 2b. So when you substitute and simplify, we get the normalization constant a is equals to 2b by pi whole raised to 1 by 4. Because when you bring it on right hand side, they are going to become reciprocal of each other. So 1 by root of pi by 2b can be written as root of 2b by pi. And when you take the square root on both the sides, we get the value of a as shown. So when you substitute this value back into the wave function, we get the normalized wave function, which is nothing but xi of x is equals to 2b by pi whole raised to 1 by 4 into exponential of minus bx square. In the same way, we need to simplify different wave functions for normalization. It may be sine function or any trigonometric functions, anything. Easily using the same approach, the wave functions are to be normalized. Next, let us solve for another question. That is, it is a combination of both. Here we need to normalize also, as well as we need to find some variables or eigenvalue based on the Hermitian operator only. So using all the information whatever we have studied till now is applicable here, and this type of question will be asked for the competitive exams, but it is very simple. Here an operator h cap equal to minus d square by dx square plus x square is already given, and it is said that it is a Hermitian operator of the system. Here we need to show that nx exponential of minus x square by 2 is an eigenfunction of h cap, and we know eigenfunction is based on the eigenvalue equation. That is, when an operator is operated on a wave function, it regenerates the same wave function with a constant value, and that constant is eigenvalue and the wave function is eigenfunction. So we need to check the same here, whether this wave function nx exponential of minus x square by 2, whether it is an eigenfunction when you use the operator h cap, which is given as minus d square by dx square plus x square. And when you solve it, if you are getting it as an eigenfunction, means you are getting eigenvalue also. So what is the eigenvalue? And also we need to evaluate n. N is nothing but the normalization constant. So let's start it. So let us solve for h cap into xi, because both are given. We need the answer to be equal to some constant into the same function nx into exponential of minus x square by 2. If we get so, then we can say this wave function is an eigenfunction. So here I am substituting the value of h cap as minus d square by dx square plus x square into the wave function is nx into exponential of minus x square by 2. When you solve it, we need to take the double differentiation. So I am taking single differentiation at first and later we can differentiate again. So minus as it is, n is constant taken outside, d by dx I am keeping as it is, again d by dx of nx exponential of minus x square by 2. N is outside, so x is u and exponential term is acting like v. Differentiation of u into v is u into differentiation of v plus v into differentiation of u. So x as it is, exponential term will remain as it is. Again, differentiation of exponential, that is minus x square by 2, will be minus 2x divided by 2. 1 by 2 is constant. 2x differentiation is 2x. X square differentiation is 2x. So 2 will get cancelled and plus. Now exponential term is kept constant and differentiation of x is 1. So this is a single differential of this. Again, in the operator we are having the second term, that is plus x square. So we just need to multiply it with the wave function. So we are getting nx cube exponential of minus x square by 2. Then in the next step, again we need to differentiate it. So I have just simplified and written as minus n d by dx of, as 2 are getting cancelled, minus x square exponential of minus x square by 2 plus exponential of minus x square by 2 plus n x cube exponential of minus x square by 2. So here again we are having two terms depending on x, that is d by dx of minus x square into exponential of minus x square by 2. That's why we again need to use the formula differentiation of u into v, which is nothing but u into differentiation of v plus v into differentiation of u. The same thing I have done here, and when you solve it, finally you are getting some terms, that is, be careful when you are putting the signs. So first term, we are having three negative signs, that's why it is going to be negative n x cube exponential of minus x square by 2. Then second term, there are minus n into minus of 2x into exponential of minus x square by 2. So it is plus 2x. Then third term is, again we are having minus, minus and minus. So one term is going to become plus because it is a second term, minus n into minus x exponential of minus x square by 2. It will be nx exponential term, then plus last term as it is. And clearly we can observe here, first and last term are going to cancel out. And second and third term are equal. So we can add it. That is nx exponential of minus x square by 2 and nx exponential of minus x square by 2 two times. So when you add it, it is going to be 3nx exponential of minus x square by 2. So what we can see here is we have got the same wave function with a constant. When h cap is operated on the given wave function, it means that nx exponential of minus x square by 2 is a eigenfunction of h cap. And also from the same thing we can say that 3 is the eigenvalue of this equation. So this is one part of the problem. Next we need to evaluate what is the value of n, that is normalization constant. For that again we need to use the normalization condition, which is nothing but integration from minus infinity to plus infinity of xi star xi into d tau is equals to 1. Xi value is given, xi star is obvious, that is complex conjugate, it is going to remain as it is. So when you solve it, you are having another standard integral which we have already seen in our different classes, and when you solve it, the integral value is going to be equal to square root of pi by 2. And that's why we are getting n is equals to 2 by pi whole raised to 1 by 4. So mainly we need to know some of the standard integrals when we come across such problems. And when you put this n value, you are getting the eigenfunction as xi is equals to 2 by pi whole raised to 1 by 4 into x into exponential of minus x square by 2. So this is another type of problem which we have solved, where we find out the eigenvalue by proving that the wave function is an eigenfunction and operator is already given. Finally, we need to evaluate the normalization constant. Then let us move on to another type of problem which may be asked based on bracket notation. So again, this is a kind of competitive exam question where we are going to consider a system, or it is given that to consider a system whose state is given in terms of an orthonormal set of three vectors, ket phi 1, ket phi 2 and ket phi 3, as ket xi is equals to the combination of the three wave states, that is root 3 by 3 ket phi 1 plus 2 by 3 ket phi 2 plus root 2 by 3 ket phi 3. So xi is expressed in terms of phi 1, phi 2, phi 3 vectors. Here we are having three parts in the question. Let us solve one by one. So first part is A. We need to verify whether ket xi is normalized or not. And also we need to calculate the probability of finding the system in each of the state ket phi 1, phi 2 and phi 3. So question may look little bit difficult, but solution is very simple, because all the things are given directly. First we need to verify whether the vector xi is normalized or no. Here again we need to consider the normalization condition, which is nothing but xi integration of minus infinity to plus infinity of xi star into xi into d tau is equals to 1. And we know in bracket notation we are just writing the normalization condition, as we can see. And here we are already given with ket function, and its conjugate will be the bra function. So both the functions I have written here, just that the notations are going to change. If there is a complex term, we need to write its conjugate, but here all are real terms, so just notations are going to change. That is, ket notation will be changing into bra notation and bra notation to the ket notation. And we know the bra notation is always a conjugate function. Here just we are going to find out its value, that is inner product of the two function will be equal to just multiplying it. It is root 3 by 3 into ket into bra phi 1 into root 3 by 3 into ket phi 1. So here it is something like a dot b. It will be a1 b1 plus a2 b2 plus a3 b3. The same thing we are just multiplying here, and using the condition, that is Kronecker delta, directly we can say that the inner product of phi 1 and phi 2, phi 1 and phi 3, or when 1 and m and n are not equal, it is going to vanish out. That's why we are having only the inner product of the same states, that is phi 1 phi 1, phi 2 phi 2 and phi 3 phi 3. And other term, that is constant, root 3 by 3, 2 by 3, root 2 by 3, are just going to multiply each other. So when you solve it, we know that inner product of phi 1 and phi 1 is 1, phi 2 phi 2, phi 3 phi 3, it is going to be equal to 1, and squares of these functions are 3 by 9, 4 by 9 and 2 by 9. When you add it, you are getting 1 as the answer. And by this we can say that normalization condition is verified and the wave function whichever is given is normalized. So one part of A is completed. Next we need to calculate the probability of finding the system in each of the state, that is probability of finding xi in phi 1, xi with respect to phi 2 and phi 3. Here probability we know that it is nothing but square of mod of xi, that is xi star into xi. Here we are considering with different states. So p1 will be with respect to phi 1 and the probability will be as shown, that is square of mod of the inner product of phi 1 with xi. And xi is already defined in the question itself. So just putting the value, we know inner product of phi 1 and phi 2, phi 1 and phi 3, they are going to vanish out because of Kronecker delta. Only with respect to same values, that is inner product of phi 1 and phi 2 will remain and it will be equal to 1. That's why p1 will be equal to root 3 by 3 whole square, which is nothing but 3 by 9. In the same way, we need to find out the probability of finding the system in the state phi 2. So here other terms, first and last term will be getting cancelled and the second term will be inner product of phi 2 with phi 2. That's why we are getting 2 by 3 whole square, that is 4 by 9. And similarly, the probability p3, that is finding a probability of finding a system in the state phi 3 will be equal to 2 by 9. So first part of the problem is completed. So next let us see the B part, that is we need to verify that the total probability is unity. That is, we have already found out the probability of finding the system in the state phi 1, phi 2, phi 3. And now we need to verify whether the total probability is unity or no. Unity means 1. Means we need to just add all the probabilities and check whether it is going to give you 1 or no. So 3 by 9 plus 4 by 9 plus 2 by 9, it is nothing but 1. And thus we can say the total probability is unity. Then the next part is we need to consider an ensemble of 810 identical system. Ensemble is nothing but you can say collection of states. So this is a statistical term. So consider an ensemble of 810 identical system and they are saying that each one of them in the state xi calc, each one of state, they are in state xi. So now we need to calculate the number of system that will be found in each of these states phi 1, phi 2, phi 3. Means what is the contribution of the system with respect to each state? Means in state phi 1, how many identical system will be present? In state phi 2, how many again system will be present? That we need to find out. Again, it is going to be very simple. The number of system found in the state phi 1 is given using the probability. That is, n1 will be equal to the total number of system into the probability of finding the system in state phi 1. So multiply by p1, which we have already found out, we get n1 is equals to 270. And in the same way, we need to find out the number of system found in state phi 2. That is, multiplying the total number of system into the probability of finding the system in state phi 2, which is equals to 4 by 9, we get the answer n2 is equals to 360. In the same way, we can find out n3, which gives the number of system found in the state phi 3. That will be equal to 810 into 2 by 9 equal to 180. And we can observe that when you just add these answers n1 plus n2 plus n3, it will be equal to capital N, that is the total number of identical system, which is nothing but 810. So in this way we can just cross verify whether our answers are correct or no. So question is lengthy, but answer is very simple, and in such way we need to solve different questions based on Hermitian operator or a commutator or even normalization, again based on the probability also. Just we need to know with respect to integration and bracket notations how the terms are going to change. So these are some of the problems which I had chosen. I hope it will be clear for you. Thank you.